We have two ways of dealing with unwanted content in Photoshop on the iPad. And what I'm going to do here is just zoom in just for a second on this kind of corner of the image, because you may have noticed there's a tunnel across the top side here, and also there's a road going along here, and this lake isn't what I want in this particular composition just here, and there's a couple of other bits as well. This is a fab place, by the way, called Kerrang in the Isle of Skye in Scotland. If you ever get the chance to visit, I think you should, and I definitely should too, because I've only seen it in pictures. But anyway, I want to get rid of these. The seventh icon down, I think it's the seventh, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, is the healing tools. And we have a clone stamp here and a healing brush. Let's go with the clone stamp to start off with. And now we have some brush controls to look at. The first of which is the numeric field for the size. Now, if you tap on that, you will either get, if you tap with your finger, you will get a numeric entry field, although it seems to be not wanting to do that for me just at the moment. But if you tap and drag across it, then you have this slider as well here. So I'm just going to make that slightly larger. Then on the icon underneath, I can change the hardness. So I want this sort of medium hard, about 30 something, just there. Underneath that, I've got the opacity. Well, I'm going to go with full opacity there, I think. And then underneath, we have an option for the clone source, but we can also access that using the touch shortcut. So we'll have a look at that in just a second. Before we do, there's an ellipsis there which tells us what we can sample. So it's the current layer, the current and the layers below, or all layers. You can also determine how you use pressure for opacity and or pressure for size. Okay, so let's go ahead and tap this icon here to select a source. So to get rid of the lake, I'm going to go just beneath that for the moment. And then when I start painting, you can see that the source is following me along just there. I'm now going to hold down the touch shortcut, which allows me to sample the source as well. It's much more interactive that way. I'm just going to undo that because that wasn't very clean. Just there, let's go ahead and do that. There we are. That's much better. And then I'm going to select more of a source here, kind of blend those things together. And at this point, normally I would start to soften off my brush. In fact, I'm going to do that just now. So I'll make the hardness there very, very low indeed, and sample some other pieces here. It's frequently sometimes change the brush size and just dab some of these in. Okay, to make that a bit softer. I'm going to go for a much, much bigger brush here just for the minute. I think that's possibly too large. There we go, something like that. Again, get some source here and then just dab that in. Now I'm using pressure for size, so I have to press quite hard there. There we go, and I think that's blending okay. Now the next one is the healing brush. Now this one, I'm going to go quite big on the brush like so, and I'm going to try doing this in one pass. It's not always the best strategy, I've got to be honest, but I'm going to give it a go. I am going to paint continually over this area, including that one where there's a car parked, just here, and then along here to about that point there. Look at that, that's not bad. And then I'll get over the rest of the tunnel here. Perfect. That actually is really, really good. Let's do a couple of other little bits here because that worked out really, really well. Just there, okay, and maybe just at the top there, that's where some of the sky remnant is. In fact, that's to its detriment, so I'll just undo that a couple of times, change my brush size here like so, and just brush over that little bit just there. There we are. Brilliant. So there you are. If you've got things that you want to remove, those are a couple of options you've got just there. You've got the healing brush and the clone stamp tool.